All praises be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us opportunity to come to Juma, because Juma is a great thing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Man taraka thalatha juma'atin mutawaliyat, falan tuqbal salatuhu." Anybody who leave 3 Juma consecutively without any uzur, without any reasons, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be angry with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not like you. You know that it's Juma, you have time, nothing, you don't have any excuse, just relaxing. You don't come to Juma consecutively 3 weeks, subhanallah, Allah will be angry with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the anger of Allah on us. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we testify there is no God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we testify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one worthy to be worshipped. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have right on us. We have right on Allah. Our right on Allah is the one who created us. He must take care of us. And Allah has done it. Allah has done what He's supposed to do. Allah has given us shelter. Allah has given us food. Allah has given us everything. Now, what is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? حَقُّ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا. What Allah have on us for us to worship Him, to follow His command. That is what Allah is seeking from us. And look at wonderful God. Inasmuch as He did what He's supposed to do, and then He wants us to worship Him, and then He also promised when we worship Him, He's going to reward us. He can choose not to reward us, but you're supposed to worship because He is your Lord. But Allah is wonderful. He promised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not break His promise. He said, anybody who worship me, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. What did Allah say? كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُلَى خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا لَا يَبَغُونَ عَنْهَا حِوَلًا. Indeed, those who believe in me and do good deed, كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتِ. Jannah will be there for them. نُزُلَى, abode. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they shall be there permanently. Dwellers of Jannah. May Allah give us Jannah. Brothers and sisters, we declare our beloved Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the great messenger of Allah. Why is it the great? Because every messenger of Allah, Allah sent him to particular people, but Prophet Muhammad to everything. Not only mankind, the jinn are included. وَالشَّجَرَ وَالدَّوَابِ, the animals are included. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَجَّمَادَاتُ هَذَا الْكَوْنُ تَدْرِي مُحَمَّدًا. Even the non-living things of this world know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because there is a palm tree in the masjid of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he used to give khutbah, he leaned on this palm tree and gave khutbah. One time, a lady came and said, Ya Rasulullah, why don't you let me build? My son is a carpenter. He can build something like this for you to stand on. And then the boy came and did the minbar for Prophet Muhammad. The first day Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stepped on this minbar, this palm tree. And this palm tree is not living, it's already finished. Only the half of it. Subhanallah. It started, the tree started shouting in the masjid. Everyone who was in the masjid that day can hear the sound. Everybody are confused. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is the palm tree. She is talking about me. She said, why did I leave laying on it? Subhanallah. So everything, not living thing, when najm was shajar, everything know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the one Yahud. Prophet Muhammad said, every animal know me. And he was holding an animal. And then he said, ask this animal that you are having. What? Who am I? And the Prophet said, Mana ana ya hadha al-hayawan fakan anta Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So everything knows Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. That is why he's a great prophet. And We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the ummah. So when you wake up, you have to give thanks to Allah for you being among the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We send our salutation to him and his family and the Sahaba and those who follow their footsteps until the day of judgment today. May Allah bless all of them.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, our khutbah today is about things that one can do, the cause of Allah be on him. We must know, may Allah forbid us from the cause of Allah.
Amen.
There are things people are doing, human being that Allah created you, and you allow the cause of Allah to be on you, may Allah forbid us. One, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَمَاتُوا هُمْ كُفَّارُ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ أَجْمَعِينَ. He said, indeed, those who refuse to obey command of Allah, they denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, they denying Allah, but as time goes on, they come to accept it. But they didn't accept it until they die in denial of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, if the curse of Allah will be upon them, even when they are buried in the graveyard, the curse of Allah will be upon them. And not only Allah, Allah asked the angels to send curses upon them and human beings to send curses upon them because they refuse to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something, subhanallah, is very difficult for human being to see your fellow brother, maybe your friend, your countryman, who denying the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you see him, anybody who, when you want to see somebody who the cause of Allah is on him, is somebody who don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if there is a chance for you not to be with him, be far away from him, because the cause may touch you. May Allah forbid us. Secondly, man yartadda ba'da imanihi, that is our problem now. Man yartadda, anybody who make rida, who was Muslim, accepted Islam, and then later he said, I'm not Muslim. Subhanallah. And nowadays it happened. A lot of Muslims are changing, denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After they have recognized Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one, they have recognized Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But some of them, they don't deny Allah, but they deny Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because when you leave Islam and you go to Christianity, automatically you didn't deny Allah, but you deny Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what it is denial of Prophet Muhammad is subhanallah, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he created us, we Muslimin, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah sit behind and look at you and said, anything about me, leave, follow Prophet Muhammad. Follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, kul in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah. When you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leave Allah, follow Prophet Muhammad. Because you cannot say Muhammad except you say Rasulullah. So long as Allah come in, you are still talking to Allah. That's why when you follow Prophet Muhammad, automatically you follow Allah. But you can follow Allah without following Prophet Muhammad. And nowadays, since Prophet Muhammad was born, any religion that anybody embark, this religion is not accepted. Inna al-Din inna Allah al-Islam. So the best religion now after Prophet Muhammad was born is Islam. Any religion you embark on is not accepted by Allah. Why? Because you don't recognize Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you can do your religion and still recognize Prophet Muhammad, then that's up to you. And if you recognize Prophet Muhammad, then you must follow the command of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That means you must leave what you are doing and come to Islam. So that's the shart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us our sins. So anyone who deny Islam after he knows Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, curse of Allah will be on you. Why am I saying this? Because alhamdulillah, we are Muslimin. But there is something attached to it. We may be friends to those who deny Allah, who deny Prophet Muhammad, and we are together with them. What do you think Allah will do to you? This, the curse of Allah is on this man.
and you are always with him, maybe you are sharing ideas. Most of his ideas is the ideas that is insult to Allah, to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Most of the people who deny Islam, the very thing you hear from them, they are accusing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they are accusing Allah, like what happened in Surah Yasin. Kuffar, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when they are told, feed the poor people, they said, how can we feed people that if Allah love, they will feed? Why do you want us to feed? What is that? It's an accusation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anyone who denies Islam, you definitely accuse Prophet Muhammad or pour insult on Prophet Muhammad. And one insult of Prophet Muhammad can destroy the nation. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.